sorry about this afternoon, Anthony. I told Craig to let you know I wasn't available, but you insisted on coming anyway.
I thought we were friends, Robert. I thought there was a trust between us.
Oh, come on. If this is going to be a lecture about friendship, I'm sure we both have better things to do.
You see what I mean? You never used to resent my advice.
Well, what I resent is your intrusion into my privacy. I do have a life of my own, don't I? Away from your orders. I think I've done enough for you in the last 5 years to deserve that.
All I wanted was a meeting, but you chose to ignore me. You made me seek you out. Is that any way to treat the man who gave you your start?
I'm grateful, Anthony, but I have paid you back with interest. I built an empire for you. That doesn't give you the right to own my time or my personal life.
It's not like you to be so touchy, Robert. You're usually so in control.
Why are you here?
To be among friends.
The real reason.
All right. We need to discuss Eden Castillo. Just what does she mean to you? And this time I want the truth.
Every time Mr. Barr tried to talk about something personal, you changed the subject. What is it you don't want me to hear?
I was trying to get him to tell me about the man from the helicopter. Exactly what you wanted me to do. Why are you looking for reasons to accuse me? Misunderstood me. And now so are you.
I don't have to look for reasons to be suspicious. You're handing them to me.
Well, so why don't you just take me down to headquarters and make it official? I'm your wife. I'm not some sort of suspect. Please don't treat me like one.
I'm not accusing you of anything except being afraid. And that's what scares me.
What is it you think I'm afraid of?
I don't know. I don't have the slightest idea. But it obviously has something to do with Robert and the past. And I need you to tell me what it is.
What if I told you there was nothing to tell?
I'd say you were lying.
Do you know how it makes me feel to hear you say that?
Probably about the way it makes me feel to say it.
I love you. You're the only man in my life. Isn't that enough answer for you?
Eden, I'm tired of you answering my questions with questions.
Well, you know, maybe I'm as confused about your attitude as you are about mine.
Eden Capwell has nothing to do with our business together.
You keep saying that, but she's always there. She was there today on the boat, making it impossible for us to talk. It's not good planning, Robert. You usually keep a tight rein on the women you're involved with, but this one seems to have gotten the upper hand.
You have no idea what you're talking about.
I can't believe you haven't considered the possibility that she's using you.
Believe me, if she is using me, it's for reasons that you can't even imagine.
Then tell me what her reasons are.
They're personal. They go back a lot further than this takeover or Barr Enterprises or you or anything else.
Mystery woman from the past. How cliche.
I'm not interested in your assessment. There are things about me that you'll never know, and that's the way I want it.
No! This is the way I want it. No personal involvement with any of the Capwells. It's a danger to you, a danger to me, to our future, Robert. You knew it wasn't going to end with the takeover. Believe me, my friend, it's only the beginning.
Still using the name Capwell. It's like rubbing our noses in a defeat.
Well, I think he's doing a lot more than that, Mr. C.
Why, you found out something?
What's wrong?
Only what's been wrong for weeks now, Robert Barr.
Isn't there anyone in this family who isn't talking about Robert Barr?
Eden doesn't. And I wish to God I could understand why.
David.
Hi.
Beautiful, aren't they? These weren't more than 100 yards away from here. Practically on my doorstep. We're lucky to live where we do.
We used to feel that way.
Before I came? Well, I managed to do the exact opposite of what I set out to do. Did you hate me?
I don't hate you. I thought of this as some surrender if I didn't pick up the pieces of my life I didn't remember. That it was a test of character. And I should just look at it and deal with it head on. And I thought to myself, why? I mean, what's the point? It has nothing to do with my life now.
It has everything to do with you, and you know it. That's why you've gone as far as you have. That's why you're not going to be able to stop until you know everything. It's why you still need me.
Oh, no one's as indispensable as you wish you were.
Well, you think these are just about you? You think this has been easy for me? Sometimes I want to just grab you and shake you until you remember. Because when you do remember, there are questions I have, Eden. The questions I've been waiting to ask
for
years.
Yeah, well, you can't make me love you again.
What I am trying to do by helping you to remember the past is to hand you your future.
What I want from the future and what you want from the future are two different things.
Well, why don't you tell me what you want?
I want to see my children grow up. I want to see them walk out here on the beach and pick up shells like that and bring them to me and ask me, what are they? I want to walk these stretches of beach with my children and my grandchildren and I don't want to walk inside my house and I want to feel that same sense of joy as the very first day that I walked in there and I thought to myself, you know, my life is filled with promise.
It's strange to think that something lived in here once. It looks as if it were made just to catch the light and be admired. But it wasn't. It was down on the ocean floor in the dark. Protecting what was inside from all the things that might go wrong. It's hard to believe that something this beautiful could be a prison, but it is a prison. It's the same. 10 years ago, you and I belonged to each other. You became a thief, like me. You turned your back on who you were so you could try to find out who you wanted to be. Now, I'm not going to let you tell me that didn't happen and didn't mean anything.
Could Eden be afraid of to tell you?
That she knew Robert Barr. Some time ago. Before we were married, before she even knew me.
That's ridiculous. Why wouldn't she say something when he first came to town? Why would she keep it a secret?
I think something happened between the two of them that she can't talk about, maybe because he won't let her talk about
it. Wait a minute. Are you saying that Barr is blackmailing Eden?
I don't know what the hell else to think, Mr. C. I can't believe that my wife would be hiding things from me of her own free will.
Oh, no. This may have something to do with that mystery man who's pulling the strings behind Barr.
Maybe, but how would I know? You know, I can't find out anything about this case. It's like some no exit, you know? It's like every time I turn around, I run into another wall.
If Eden were in trouble, you'd be the first person she'd go to.
And how do you explain her silence?
Well, she's, I don't know, going through a difficult time. The takeover has frustrated her, made her angry. Maybe she just needs a little more time.
Yeah, but if that were all it was, she'd be talking to me about that, right? There's got to be something else. You know, she was open for a while when she first started having these images of drowning. She didn't know if they were visions or dreams or whatever the hell they were. And then one day she described one of them to me as a remembered experience. And from that day forward, I have been excluded. I can't even bring up the subject without being told in so many words to mind my own business. Now, can either of you remember anything traumatic that might have happened to her that had something to do with water?
She's confided in me about these episodes, but I was gone most of the time that she was growing up, so I really can't attribute to anything. I don't know.
Well, I was wondering about something. A few days ago, she was asking me questions about drowning. We were reminiscing about the summers we used to spend cruising with the yacht.
When was that?
He was in the late teens, I guess, just before college. We used to go away island hopping for a month or so, do you remember? She asked me about if she had any accidents during that time, during those months.
But there wasn't any.
No, not then, but she did have one in Switzerland in a car. She was unconscious for 3 or 4 days. When she woke up, the doctor said she didn't know where she was.
And how long did that go on?
That means it was just temporary. But suppose she could have lost some of her memory that they weren't aware of.
That would explain the frequency of the episodes. Things could be coming back to her in fragments.
Yeah, and Robert Barr is one of the fragments. That would make sense.
Wait.
Oh, thanks, Cyril. You both jumped to the conclusions. I was keeping very close tabs on her that time. And I don't remember any involvement she ever had with Robert Barr. I certainly remember his name. Maybe it's Eden's past we should forget about and look a little closer into Robert Barr's.
He doesn't seem to have one, Mr. C. I've never seen anything like it.
Cruz, he bought his slate clean. Very simple. Something he could buy could be unbought, remember?
What do you mean I became a thief like you?
Well, you played the part of a poor girl very well. You had me fooled completely.
I didn't tell you I was a Capwell.
You told me you were just like me.
So what did I do to prove that? What were the stakes?
I'm Dean.
I should have known. I hope there's nothing of any real value here. Because that guy is not going to protect it.
No, there's plenty of value here, but the poor people on the town have too much respect for the artist to steal anything. So there isn't much need for security.
So you never really thought of stealing anything just for the thrill?
I told you, my theft is for more noble reasons.
You stole me.
Ah.
Was that a noble reason?
No, that was for another reason altogether. Come here. I'll show you something. Favorite piece. It's called Undine, La Serena.
The mermaid.
Yeah. Beautiful, isn't she?
Exquisite.
I used to think she was the most perfect work of art I've ever seen.
Why the past tense?
But now I've found you.
I don't even come close.
Hey, you surpass.
So we love him as both.
Well, I'd love to, but this baby's already been claimed. I have a dealer or a collector already bought it.
So?
What are you suggesting there, Eden?
Don't you know mermaids die under glass?
Is this a new version of an old legend or what?
My version. Our version. A Tale of Two Thieves.
I like it.
Hey, Papa. There you are. You've been gone for a while.
Yeah. I was talking with your brother.
How is my brother?
Sure, Roger. You'll be glad to know that he got himself a new job. Mm-hmm.
Yeah, I could just imagine head honcho for Robert Barr's goon squad, right? Oh, yeah, I'm sure he wouldn't describe it like that to you. I'm sure he tried to make it sound like it was something important, something worthy to you.
You know, actually, he didn't sound too happy, come to think of it.
Yeah, so why doesn't he get another job then? I mean, this is America. You don't like what you're doing, you do something else, right? But that's not going to happen with Ricky. As long as he's got a little money in his pocket and doesn't have to do too much, he's happy enough.
I argued with him. I'm worried about him.
Yeah? Well, the last thing he needs is your sympathy, I'll tell you that.
I'm not talking about sympathy. I'm talking about help. I mean, let's face it, your brother's all mixed up. A lot of it is my fault.
would be nice if maybe you go over and try to smooth things over with him, huh?
Papa?
Yes.
He put a family I care about through a lot of suffering because he sold them out. I don't want to smooth things over with him. It was all I could do not to mop the floor with him.
Well, for your information, there happens to be another family who is also suffering because of this lack of understanding of both of you. And your brother's going to get into more trouble just to show you that he can.
Yeah, well, I'm sorry. But I've given him as many chances as I can muster. I've got more important things to think about, like how this little deal he made with Robert Barr is affecting my wife, for instance.
We're not talking about business anymore, are we, Cruz?
Business? No, Papa, I'm not sure we were ever talking about business.
I don't like that look in your eye. It worries me.
My wife is in trouble. She's drifting. All this talk about drowning, it's happening. She's going down. She doesn't know why. I don't know what the hell to do about it. I'm like the jerk on the beach who can't swim.
Barr then just come into a town and turn the lives of so many people upside down in such a short amount of time. Who is this man?
I don't know who this man is. I swear to God, I bet everybody I can think of trying to figure that out. Checking his background, like the man didn't exist until 5 years ago. Like he was born 5 years ago. He doesn't show up in any of the usual records.
How far are you going to go with the investigation then? Hmm?
I don't know, Papa. I'll tell you one thing. If he hurts my wife, I'm gonna kill him.
So I pretended to be a thief like you. Did you consider that a conquest?
It took me by surprise. Believe me, it wasn't something I planned for you to do.
You know, I remember these things, but it's not like they're a piece of my life. It's like remembering a play I've seen. I remember the scenes. I remember the actors, but I don't remember the feelings.
They're too important for you to forget. You will remember them.
Yeah.
Look, this doesn't have to be a battle between us, even.
All right. So what happened next? Obviously, you kept on Dean all these years.
You gave it to me as a present. The second most important thing you ever gave me.
And I suppose the first was my heart. Spare me the gothic romance, Robert.
You stole from me. Why would you do something like that if it didn't matter? Are you sure this is something you want to do?
What are you, chicken? You know, I need a plan.
We break in, we steal it, we come back, and make love. I always think simple plans are the best.
Yeah, but you also said the security system was lax. What if they have an alarm system?
No.
Okay, so they don't have an alarm system. You know the guy who sleeps all day? Maybe he's up all night.
All right, here's the deal. They're having a change of guard in about half an hour. Now, the one who's arriving is always a little late. The one who's trying to leave doesn't like to wait around. So there's about 5 minutes when there's nobody there. So for 5 minutes, the museum is ours.
You've already thought of stealing on the museum.
Only a few thousand times, but I never really thought it was going to follow through.
Well, you're going to do it now.
No. You're going to steal her.
No.
Not me.
No. It is not me, and it's not you. It's us. Okay?
Don't make promises like that unless you plan to keep them.
We're getting ahead of ourselves here. That's right. Come on. On Dean Lake. If he'd known who I was from the beginning, would it have made any difference?
I don't know. Probably would have fallen in love with you no matter what.
And you never suspected anything. I was that good of an actress.
Yeah, you were for a while. Stealing Ondine should have tipped me off. It was way too capricious. It's the kind of thing only a rich girl would be able to do without worrying about the consequences.
Actually, lately I've been doing quite a lot of thinking. Why people would be so wealthy and steal. Ever since you took Capital Enterprises, in fact.
That was business. Ondine was love. You got 5 minutes, that's all. Even less if the guard shows up.
Okay. Make him count. What was that?
Let me check it out.
Robert?
Just what the hell do you think you're doing here, miss?
I don't like to come here when there's crowds.
Let's try again.
I came to...
Call my name out for it. That's what tipped him off.
Yeah, I'm sorry. I was worried.
Forget about it. Let's get out of here.
No, not without our name. Every second.
Tell me you love me.
I thought I gave you proof.
That was just a hint.
I have to definitely give you proof.
Still have doubts about what happened?
I know I loved you. And it doesn't seem real.
You were the first woman I ever loved. I know I was the first man you ever loved. It was real. It just didn't have a chance to become what it could have been and what it should have been.
Why?
You'll remember that too, soon.
I'm not going to change anything.
Don't say that.
There are reasons why I forgot. It wasn't just a simple bump on the head. I don't believe that. It was a choice. It may have been subconscious, but it was a choice. I suppose I saw all that as a way to rebel. As a way to dare myself to be different. And it's okay when you're a child, but it isn't when you're a grown-up.
You were not a child. I was there. I made love to you. You were a woman.
Did you realize? The only person that you're hurting is yourself by making me remember this stuff. It's not like you can freeze something in time. This is a living, breathing human being you're talking about. You move on. You heal. You learn to love again. And if you're unbelievably lucky like I have been, you have something like Cruz. It endures. It's just not a summer, a few moments. It's something that lasts a lifetime.